This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I'm going to discuss five properties of parallelograms and show how you can prove the properties. So here are the five properties. The opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel. The consecutive angles are supplementary. The opposite angles are congruent. The opposite sides are congruent. And the diagonals bisect each other. So let's look at each property separately. The opposite sides of a parallelogram are parallel. Okay, well, since the definition of a parallelogram is a four-sided figure that has its opposite sides parallel, this property is just part of the definition. So it's given. It's given by the definition. The second property says consecutive angles are supplementary. Here's what that means. If I've got a parallelogram, we'll call it ABCD, angles A and B are consecutive. As I go around the parallelogram, they occur one after the other. So angles A and B are consecutive, B and C would be consecutive, C and D would be consecutive, and then D and A would be consecutive. So let's show that angles A and B are supplementary. If they're supplementary, then we can show that the rest of them are the same way. So I'm going to take side AB and extend it. So what I've got here is two parallel lines, the base of the parallelogram and the top, or side AD and sides BC. We know they're parallel because that's part of the definition of a parallelogram. Side AD, which I've extended, is a transversal that cuts across those two parallel lines. Now, when I extended side AB, I formed an exterior angle. That exterior angle is congruent with the interior angle at A because these are corresponding angles along that transversal. Now, that exterior angle at B is supplementary to the interior angle at B. They share an adjacent side, and they lie along a straight angle. Okay, so those two are supplementary, but we know that exterior angle is equal to angle A. So that means A and B must be supplementary. In the same way, we could prove that B and C are supplementary. We could extend side BC and prove that. Then we could go around and prove that C and D are supplementary. And then we'd see that D and A are supplementary. Okay, so now we know the consecutive angles are supplementary. The next property says the opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. Well, given what we know so far, that's going to be easy to show. Angle A and angle B are supplementary because they're consecutive angles. Now, angle B and C must also be supplementary because they're consecutive angles. But if angle A and B are supplementary and angle C and B are supplementary, then angle A must equal angle C, and those are opposite angles, so they're congruent. We can prove the same thing for angle D. We can show that because that's supplementary to angle C, it must be congruent with angle B. Okay, so there we've got a proof that the opposite angles are congruent. The next property says that the opposite sides are congruent. Let's get rid of some of these extra notations and show that that's true. So I'm going to draw a diagonal. I'll draw it from B to D. It wouldn't matter if you drew from B to D or if you connected A and C with a diagonal. Okay, so now I've made two triangles. I'm going to prove that these two triangles are congruent. I already know that angle A and angle C, which are opposite angles, are congruent. The diagonal that I drew, BD, is a transversal it cuts across two parallel lines. So the opposite interior angles of that transversal are going to be congruent with each other. That's one of the things we know about parallel lines. I've got two angles, two sets of angles that are congruent with each other, and I've got a side that both of the triangles share. They both share side BD. So what I've got is congruency by angle, angle, side for those two triangles. If those two triangles are congruent, their corresponding sides must be congruent. That means side AB is going to be congruent with side CD. Now, those are opposite sides of the parallelogram. The same thing happens with side AD and side BC. Those are opposite sides of the parallelogram. So therefore, we know that the opposite sides are congruent. The last thing we want to prove is the property that says that the diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other. I'm going to erase all this and draw a new parallelogram so we can just look at the facts that we need. Okay, so I've got a new parallelogram. Once again, I'll label it ABCD. And I'm going to draw two diagonals, one connecting BD, or B and D, and the other connecting angles A and C. And what I want to prove is that each of these diagonals bisects the other one. Let's label the place where they intersect point E. Now what I'm going to do is show that I have two congruent triangles. I know that the opposite sides of a triangle are congruent. The opposite sides of a parallelogram are congruent. So that means AD must be congruent with BC. These diagonals are transversals, so I also know that opposite interior angles formed by those transversals are congruent. So I'm going to label the opposite interior angles, the pairs, as being congruent. And now I've got triangle CBE congruent with triangle ADE because they have an angle, side, angle congruency. Since those triangles are congruent, their corresponding sides are going to be congruent. That means side AE is going to be congruent with side CE. If those two sides are congruent, then basically their lengths are the same, and therefore diagonal AC has been cut into two equal or congruent line segments, so it's been bisected. And we can show the same thing for diagonal BD. So therefore we know that the diagonals that bisect each other, or that the diagonals that cross each other bisect each other. Okay, so these are going to be your five basic properties for all parallelograms. You can memorize the properties if you want, but if you'd rather not memorize, what you can do is just know the definition of a parallelogram and derive each of these properties. Okay, so that's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.